It was the late spring, early summer of 1954. I was only two. Like all parents, mine were terrified one of us would get polio. Children were isolated in small groups. The schools and the local pools were closed. When I came down with a fever, they were relieved when I only had the summer grip, which was another name for the flu. I got better on my own in less than a week. No need for doctors, no need for quarantine signs to be nailed to our door. I had small issues that were no big deal. The word polio was never spoken, and neighbors didn't need to know. As I grew, I realized minor issues of struggling in school and muscle weakness that my mother always characterized as being clumsy due to my funny left foot. I married, had a wonderful career, and I raised two sons. As I aged, I stumbled more, was easily fatigued, and developed what seemed to be relentless chronic pain. Then, after a bad fall that required surgery, I had what was a significant and unusual reaction to anesthesia. That's what began my very long and painful, tiring 10-year process of discovery. I learned in my 40s that the summer grip was really a mild case of polio. The more difficult journey was discovering that the late effects of the virus had taken over my body. I have the long-haul damaging effects of the polio virus called post-polio syndrome, or PPS. Although I always knew I had a problem with my left leg and foot, the upper left side of my body had grown to be far more difficult to manage. I now accept the need for a leg brace, a cane, and a power chair. My upper body issues require regular physical therapy for stretching and myofascial release to reduce the pain. My limitations are significant and very clear, but never more so than when I became a grandmother and was unable to pick up those precious babies. Sadly, the miracle of the Salk vaccine came 1 year too late for me and for tens of thousands of others who were living with the lifelong effects of this terrible disease. My compassion for those experiencing the long-term effects of COVID is real, and it comes from my heart. Without question, my family realizes for sure that no child should suffer from a vaccine-preventable disease. The pain and disability can, without question, last a lifetime.